Was it him?
No one who was here knew him well enough to identify him, other than Mr. Dufresne. But though the identity was in question, the message they left behind was clear. They claim Flint will be returning tomorrow, east of the bay, to take on recruits.
Well, if Flint is alive, if he arrives at that beach, I can't have him finding 200 men waiting there for him. No, I prefer there be no one there to meet him because no one wants to be there to meet him. Can you help see to that?
Every turn you see tonight must hear how pathetic you see Captain Flint's ploy. If you have any questions as to how to proceed, I have appointed a new madame more than capable of guiding you through it.
Good evening, girls. Open it up.
Why would she bring her back?
Make our approach off the coast.
We won't have long. Lee Charles will meet us at the rendezvous as scheduled. We'll ferry any recruits on board as quickly as possible and be on our way.
What the fuck? Is that the governor?
So that's what this is. We're all reasonable men. We all want the same thing. You offer me a pardon, I accept it. This all ends?
Maybe. Pardons are on the table.
England has shown herself to me gnarled and grey and spiteful of anyone who would find happiness under her rule. I'm through seeking anything from England except her departure from my island.
But let us be very clear about something. I am reasonable in seeking peace. But if you insist upon making me your villain, I'll play the part. From this moment on, any man participating in the act of high seas piracy will be presumed to be one of your men, an enemy of the state. I will hunt him. I will catch him. And I will hang him.
I'm really nervous. Oh man, I'm nervous.
Jack's in there?
You need to see the chest first. Step aside, let us take a look. Then we'll let him go.
Fuck that. I want to see him.
We see the chest first. Those are our orders.
No.
He ain't in there, is he?
I thought they were gonna fucking kill her. Oh, God, I was really nervous. So, she's gonna be mad. What the fuck is she gonna do? Or did they get to her already?
You better be right about this.
Woo!
Jack and the car should have been moved aboard a secret caravan to a ship waiting somewhere off the southern coast. If we can intercept that caravan, we can secure both the money to start our war and the partner to help us fight it.
Yes. It sucks that they had to hand over the cash, but Vane was 100% right. Totally made sense why. I thought maybe they had done some kind of trick. That's why I got so excited. But, you know, it's still good. Anne's okay. It's hard to pick one side because I understand people wanting a better life and not having to live crappy, kind of, I guess, you know, deprived. But then again, it's like you're under someone else's rule. You're not free, really. You're not free to do whatever you want. And so it's easy for me to understand why some of the guys are hesitant towards it because, you know, they're comfortable. The whole scene with Silver was my absolute favorite of this entire freaking episode. He was just fucking not having it. I was expecting him just to knock dude out, but nope. It was about time that guy fucking died anyway. He was a fucking traitor. I didn't like him. I am excited to see how the whole plan works out now that the governor isn't expecting basically anything to go down. I want them to be able to get Jack and the gold and get away safely. We did lose a couple guys, but that's fine. Just none of my guys. None of my main guys, okay? Well, until the next episode, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.